Good morning, all of you. In the previous classes, we were discussing about how to solve pair of linear equations. And we already discussed two methods, that is graphical method and substitution method. And today we are going to discuss a new method that is called elimination method. Elimination method. See, elimination method means eliminating one variable. That's why this word is coming, elimination. With one example, I will show you how we will do by using elimination method. What is mean by elimination method? So one question is given like this: x plus y is equal to 7 and 2x minus y is equal to 5. We have two equations. One is x plus y is equal to 7 and the other one is 2x minus y is equal to 5. And see, the word is given eliminating method, elimination method. By eliminating one variable, we need to solve x and y. We have two variables x and y here. We have two equations. We can do some operations on these equations to eliminate one variable. How can we eliminate this variable? While adding these two equations or subtracting these two equations or any other operation is possible to eliminate one variable. Can you see? For that, you just focus on the coefficients. Here the coefficient is 1 and the coefficient of x is 2. While adding, it will come 3x and while subtracting, it will come 1x. Means from this one to this one, it will come 1x. From first to second, we will get minus 1x. So, we will not eliminate x. See these coefficients of y. This is plus 1 and this is minus 1. What operation will make it as 0 while for this plus 1 and minus 1? Yes, if you are adding that two values, it will become 0. Plus 1 plus minus 1 becomes 0 because they are their negatives, means one number's negative is another number. So, one number plus its negative will make 0. Isn't it? So, we can add these two equations. Equation 1 and equation 2 we are adding. Directly you can put plus symbol and you can add because no other step is coming here. Direct addition only. 1x plus 3x it is coming. Sorry, 2x it is coming. 3x plus 1y plus minus 1y becomes 0 while adding. So, 7 plus 5 equal to 12. We got a new equation, that is 3x equal to 12. It is easy to solve x. X is equal to 12 by 3, that is 4. We got the value of x. Then next we need to get the value of y. What we can do? If we got one value, put that value in any one of the equation, you will get the another variable. So, in the first equation we are substituting 4. Put x equal to 4. In equation number 1. So, you need to give this as equation number 1 and equation number 2 to write like this. Otherwise, put x equal to 4 in x plus y is equal to 7. Like that you can write. So, x equal to 4 substituting here, it will come 4 plus y is equal to 7. So, y equal to 3. See, we got the equation solutions are x equal to 4 and y equal to 3 are the solutions of this equations. Got it? This is the elimination method. Why this word came, you understood. Why this word came? While doing some operation, one variable eliminated. Clear? That's why it is called elimination method. While adding or subtracting, one variable eliminated. Another one question. One question is given like this. X by 2 plus 2y by 3 is equal to minus 1. One equation. Another equation is x minus y by 3 is equal to 3. Two equations are given with the fraction as means fraction coefficients are coming. We don't like fraction coefficients, isn't it? What we can do to avoid fraction coefficients? See the denominator. If this denominator is 2, this denominator is 3. That means if we multiply this equation by 2, this 2 will cancel. this equation by 3, this 3 will cancel. So both should happen. 2 should go, 3 should go. So with which number we can multiply this equation? Yes, correct. 6 with 6, 2 and 3 should go. That means 6 should go. So we can multiply this equation by 6. Which gives us multiplied by 6. Which gives. Why we are doing so? Because the denominator fractions are coming as the coefficients. So denominator is there. So to avoid and to make it as integer, because we like to move, we like to play with integers more than fractions, isn't it? Okay. So into 6. So this equation, first equation, I am going to multiply by 6 because I need to avoid, we don't want this fraction. That's why. So it will come, multiply these 1, 2, 3 terms by 6. So this term into 6 means we are getting 3x plus this term into 6 means we are getting 2. 2y into 2, 4y is equal to minus 6. We got one equation without denominators. And here we need to avoid this, we need to remove this 3 in this as denominator is coming. So we can multiply by 3. So through this full equation we are multiplying by 3, which gives us 3x minus y equal to 9. 3 with the 3 we are multiplying x into 3, 3x minus y by 3 into 3, 3, 3 will cancel, we are getting y equal to 3 into 3, 9. Simple steps, that's why I am not writing that steps, directly we can write. Then see, these two equations, are given actually, we made the same equations by as in this form, means without a denominator, because we like to play with the denominator, with the integer coefficients, that's why. So, now see, x coefficients both are same, xx 3, 3, 3x, 3x, same. So we can do subtraction to eliminate the variable x. See the coefficient of x here, both are equal, that's why we are doing subtraction. If it is negative, we will select addition. So subtracting, 3x minus 3x becomes 0x, no need to write. 4 minus minus 1, 4 minus minus 1 is 5. 5y is equal to minus 6 minus 9 minus 15. So we are getting y equal to minus 3. Put this value in any one of the equation. 1, 2, 3, 4 equations are with us. Which is easy equation? I think this will be easy. Or this one. This one we can, because y equal to minus 3 will make this as easy. So in this equation we are substituting y equal to minus 3. Y equal to minus 3 in x minus y by 3 equal to 3. So x minus y is minus 3. Minus 3 by 3 is equal to 3. Minus 3 by 3 is minus 1. So this one will come in the next step, it is minus 1. Minus and minus become plus. So we are getting x plus 1 equal to 3. So we are getting x equal to 3 minus 1, that is 2. Okay. Give the value 3 into 2, 6, 6 minus, minus 3 equal to 9, correct? Any one of the equation you substitute the value, x equal to 2 and y equal to minus 3. So these two values are the solutions of this pair of equations. Understood? Then next. One more question. 5x plus 3y is equal to minus 9 and 3x minus 4y is equal to minus 17. We have two equations. See the coefficients of x and y. Are they any x coefficient or in y coefficients, are they same? Not equal. Different coefficients. So while adding or subtracting, no variable will eliminate. So what we can do? We can apply one trick, one idea we can apply. See, I am just writing here 5x plus 3y is equal to minus 9 and 3x minus 4y is equal to minus 17 are the equations. We can give this as equation number 1 and equation number 2. We got two equations. We are going to make either x coefficient or y coefficients are same. For that, we are going to multiply with a suitable number. See, I need to make y coefficients are same. That is up to you. You can decide whether x coefficients need to make it as same or y coefficient need to make it as same. I selected y coefficient because I like addition than subtraction. So if y coefficients are making equal, means I can do addition because one is positive and the other one is negative. If we are selecting x coefficients making us same, means x coefficient both are same sign, so we need to subtract, then only we will get the elimination process, isn't it? So I am selecting y coefficient are making us equal. To make y coefficients equal, first equation's y coefficient is 3 and second equation's y coefficient is 4 without sign. If I multiply this equation by 4, it will come 12. If I am multiplying the second equation by 3, this one also will come 12. So what can I do? I can multiply first equation by 4. So going to multiply first equation by 4 implies, first equation into 4 implies, full equation multiply by 4, 5x into 4, 20x plus 3 into 4, 12y is equal to minus 36. Correct. And this equation, second equation multiplied by 3. So we are getting 9x minus 12y equal to 17 into 3. 7 3s are 21, 5. We are getting 51. So minus 51. Now we got two equations. Which are the two equations? 20x plus 12y is equal to minus 36. And 9x minus 12y is equal to minus 51. Then doing addition, we are adding these two equations. We can give it as equation number 3 and 4. Then you can write equation number 3 plus 4 gives us 20 plus 9, 29x. These two adding, you will get 0 equal to minus 36 plus minus 51. You are getting minus 87. Correct, no? Minus 87. So we got 29x is equal to minus 87. So x is equal to minus 87 divided by 29. What about 29 into 3? 9 3s are 27, 2 balance, 2 3s are 6 plus 2, 8. See, correct. So we are getting x is equal to minus 3. And put this x equal to minus 3 in any one of the equation. Where we can give? Here we can give. So 5x plus 3y is equal to minus 9. X equal to minus 3. So 5 into minus 3 plus 3y equal to minus 9. So minus 15 plus 3y equal to minus 9. So 3y is equal to minus 9 plus 15. Minus 9 plus 15 is 6. So which gives us y equal to 6 by 3, that is 2. So we got the solution x equal to minus 3 and y equal to 2. That you need to write at last line. Therefore, solution x equal to minus 3 comma y equal to 2. Clear? Like this, we will make the, if at the given equations, if the coefficients are different, by suitable multiplication we will make the coefficients are same. Then we will do either addition or subtraction to eliminate one variable. Clear? Okay. So, I think you got the idea how to apply elimination method. Then few word problems are there in our textbook. We can discuss a few among them. One question is given like this. 5 years ago, Noori was thrice old as Sonu. What I told? 5 years ago, Noori's age, it was thrice as old as Sonu. One statement is given. How we will write this statement in linear form, means equation form? See, whenever you are getting like this question, in your mind, two persons should come. Isn't it? Means Noori and Sonu. Like this you write. Noori and Sonu. 5 years ago's case is given. So at present, what are their ages? Let us take it as x and y. So you need to start your answer. Let x be the age of Nuri and Sonu's age be y. Like this, you need to start. Or x and y are the ages of. Let x and y are the ages of Nuri and Sonu respectively. Like this you can write. So we took n. Like this like this you can do in the working order, and you have to give the explanation what is x and what is y, because we are taking this x and y for our purpose to do this problem, isn't it? X and y are not given in the question, so you have to mention what is x and what is y. We took here Nuri's age x and Sonu's age y. Clear? And it is given 5 years ago. What was their 5 years ago? What was their ages? Their ages was x minus 5 and y minus 5. Correct only, no? 5 years ago their ages become less than present age. So it was x minus 5 and y minus 5. Clear? That time one sentence is given. It is given. What is given? Nuri's age. 5 years ago Nuri's age is thrice of Sonu's age. Like this we will write. 5 years ago means x minus 5 is equal to thrice of Sonu's age. Make it as beautiful equation. Now we got a linear equation. Write in a standard form. X minus 5 equal to 3y minus 15. X minus 3y is equal to minus 15. I kept here this constant also going to there. It will come plus 5. So it will come minus 10. Minus 15 plus 5 minus 10. We got one equation. One equation is not enough to solve for Nuri's age and Sonu's age. Solve for x and y. So what is given? One more sentence is given. 10 years later, their ages will be like this. Nuri's age will be twice of Sonu's age. 10 years later means their age will become x plus 10 and y plus 10. At that time, it is given, at that time, their ages one connection is given. What connection is given? Also given. One more sentence is given. Also given. X plus 10 equal to Nuri's age is equal to, after 10 years, Nuri's age will be twice of Sonu's age. Like this we will write. You have to think in a very simple way. Otherwise you will make confusions. Simple way you think. Maths every problem you see, think in simple way. Normal way of thinking is enough. Then it will be, means will not make any mistake in thinking. Clear? If we made any mistake in the starting, full answer will be wrong. That is the problem of algebra. If any mistake, any small mistake we did in the starting, the remaining all steps will be wrong. Okay. So, x plus 10 is equal to 2y plus 20. Take you here. X minus 2y is equal to minus 10. Plus 10. 20 minus 10. It is coming plus 10. We are getting second equation. We got two equations. Two equations write together. Two, second equation is already here. First equation I am just writing below of this one. X minus 3y is equal to minus 10. This is our first equation. See, x coefficient is here 1 and here 1. So it is easy for us to do. No need to make them as equal. It's already equal. Doing subtraction, subtracting them. X minus x becomes 0. Minus 2 minus minus 3. You just write minus 2. Minus minus 3. So it is coming minus 2 plus 3. That is equal to 1. We are getting 1y is equal to 10 minus minus 10 is 10 plus 10. That is 2. So 20. That is 20. So we are getting it as 20. 20 means we got Sonu's age is equal to 20. Substitute y equal to 20 even in any one of the equation. Either in 1 or in 2. Which is easy? This is easy, I think. So, no, second one we can give because it is positive. Clear? So, put this one in the second equation. Second equation is given. X minus 2y is equal to 10. x minus 2y is equal to 10. So x minus 2 into 20 equal to 10. So x minus 40 equal to 10. So x is equal to 50. So we got the solution. Noori says you have to write at last. Noori's age equal to 50 and Sonu's age equal to 20. This is the answer. Clear? And one more word problem. Word problem I am explaining just to get the idea how we are making the equations while reading a sentence. Okay. Solving, we already discussed a few questions we did. I think you got the idea how to solve by using elimination method. Then, next one. Sum of a digits of a two-digit number is given 9. Sum of digits of a two-digit number is given 9. So, we have a two-digit number. We need to take 1's place and 10's place because 2 digit number. We can take this as x and this as y. Or any order, x and y. Or you, if you want here, x, here y. No problem, anyway you can take. Okay. 10's place value is x and 1's place value is y. It is given sum of digits of a 2-digit number is equal to 9. How we will write this one? Which are the digits? X and y are the digits. So their sum x plus y equal to 9. Okay, that's to get like this. I just reversed, means y wrote here and x wrote here because x plus y. Otherwise, y plus x should write now. I need x first and y second. That's why. So x plus y is equal to 9. Okay, one equation we got. One equation is ready. We need one more equation. So one more sentence is given like this. 9 times, now we got a number. Which is the number? In the tens place x and 1's place y. One number is there. 9 times this number is equal to twice of the number obtained by reversing the order of the digits. So we need to write this number. It's 9 times is equal to and twice of another number. How we are getting another number? Just reversing the order of the digits. Means x place, x will come in the 1's place and y will come in the 10's place. If you are writing like this, which is the number? Suppose it is 3 and 7. 3 and 7. Which is the number here? How we will write 3 and 7? 10's place 3 and 1's place 7 means our number is 37. How 37 is formed? 30 plus 7. So, we need to write it as 30 plus 7. This is one example. 30 plus 7. So, same way we need to write here. Yeah, suppose we are writing it as xy. Xy means in algebra, xy means x into y. In that sense, if you are writing 37 we will read it as 37. It is not 3 into 7. How 37 is formed? 30 plus 7. So we need to 3 into 10 plus 7. 3 tens and 7 ones. So we cannot write like this xy. So it will come 10x plus y. This is the number. This is not new for you because you did like this question in 8th standard and 9th standard also. Isn't it? Means if you are getting tens place and ones place digit, you will be able to write the number. 10x plus y is the number. And if we are reversing the order, it will come 10y plus x. Then the statement is given in the question. 9 times of this number. So 9 times of 10x plus y is equal to twice of the new number. So twice of 10y plus x. Okay. These two sentences are given. One equation is, this is a beautiful equation. This also we can make it as beautiful. 9 into 10, 90x plus 9y equal to 20y plus 2x. take a x and y to this side, no constant is there. So 90x minus 2x plus 9y minus 20y equal to 0. 90 minus 2, 88x minus, minus 20 plus 9 is minus 11y equal to 0. We got second equation. Then we need to apply elimination method itself. Otherwise, substitution method is easy here actually. But elimination method, we can apply because the question asked us to use elimination method. Okay, then. See here the coefficient of x 88 here 1, here coefficient of y is 11 here 1. So better to make coefficients of y as same because small number than 88, 11 is small. So we can, or you can do one thing, you can divide this, this is 11's multiple, no? So 88 is 11's multiple, 11 is 11's multiple, 0 also 11's multiple. So we can divide by 11. So I am going to divide, second equation divided by 11 implies 88 by 11 is 8x minus 11 by 11 is 1y equal to 0. So little more less coefficients we got. Okay, if you are not doing this step also, no problem. What you need to do? You need to multiply that equation by 11. Then y coefficients will be equal. Then you can do addition. Clear? Or make like this. So we got another equation, that is third equation. We noticed 88 and 11 are 11's multiple, so we divided by 11. 11 is a common factor to this equation. So, we divided by 11, we got 8x minus y equal to 0. Then write this equation also. X plus y is equal to 9. First equation, adding these two equations because minus y and plus y is the 8x plus x, 9x is equal to 9. So, we got x equal to 1. X equal to 1, you substitute in this first equation. 1 plus y is equal to 9, so y is equal to 8. So we got the number, we took 1's place and 10's place. 1's place we took it as x and y. X we got 1, y we got 8. So the number is 18. We got the number is equal to 18. Correct? Like this, word problems are there. Few more word problems are there that you do. This also you need to write in your notebook. So today's work is, you need to complete exercise 3.4. Clear? Okay. So that much only about elimination method. Then we can discuss about the next method, that is cross multiplication method. That we have the general equations, they are a1x plus b1y plus c1 is equal to 0 is our first equation, and a2x plus b2y plus c2 is equal to 0 is our second equation. We have the pair of linear equations we wrote in standard form. Now we are going to apply elimination method for solving x and y. For that we are making y coefficients are same. So first equation we are multiplying by b2, which gives us a1b2x plus b1b2y plus c1b2 is equal to 0. We got one equation. Second equation we are multiplying by b1, which implies a2b1x plus b2b1, that means b1b2y plus c2b1 is equal to 0. And we are going to subtract these two equations doing subtraction. X coefficient subtracting, so a1b2 minus a2b1 times x plus this becomes 0, c1b2 minus c2b1 is equal to 0. Then we can take a1b2 minus a2b1 times x is equal to, take this term to that side, it will come minus c1b2 and plus c2b1. So plus term I am writing first and minus term, so getting like this. So we are getting x is equal to c2b1 minus c1b2 divided by a1b2 minus a2b1. This value we are getting for x. Clear? So we got the value of x is equal to c2b1 minus c1b2 divided by a1b2 minus a2b1. Okay. Then means x value we got. We need y value. For getting y value, we are going to eliminate x. X we can write here. X is equal to C2B1 minus C1B2 divided by A1B2 minus A2B1. You don't worry, you don't need to by heart this one. Because we have a short form to write this all. We are going to make, first we eliminated y. Now we are going to eliminate x. So with which one we will multiply? We will multiply with the A2 in the first equation. So A1 A2 x plus multiplying with A2. A2 into we are doing A2 into A1, A2 into B1, A2 B1 y plus C1 A2 is equal to 0. Second equation we are multiplying by A1, A1 A2 x plus A1 B2 y plus C2 A1 is equal to 0. Okay. Then subtracting. So x will eliminate. A2 B1 minus A1 B2 times y equal to or plus C1 A2 minus C2 A1 equal to 0. And take this term to the outside and y. So y is equal to C2 A1 minus C1 A2 divided by A2 B1 minus A1 B2. Okay. Clear? X is equal to C2 B1 minus C1 B2 divided by A2 B1 minus A2 B1. This is A1 B2. Okay. Sorry, y also we can write here. Y is equal to C2 A1 minus C1 A2 divided by A2 B1 minus A1 B2. Then what about x? So x by C2 B1 minus C1 B2 is equal to y by, this I am going to change to make this denominator same. Going to make change means reverse order I am writing on the numerator denominator, so sign will adjust. So it is equal to C1 A2 minus C2 A1 divided by A1 B2 minus C2 B1 y. So y by C1 A2 minus C2 A1 is equal to 1 by A1 B2 minus A2 B1. See, x is equal to, you equate the first one and the third one, x by c, this one is equal to 1 by. So when it is going cross multiplication, we are getting x is equal to the same. And while equating second and third, you will get this one, y value. Okay. And we no need to by heart this one. We have an idea to do. That is, our general form is a1x plus b1y plus c1 is equal to 0 and a2x plus b2y plus c2 is equal to 0. This is our, then see xy1 like this you write. And here you need to write B1, C1, A1, B1. From where I started? B1. B1, C1, A1, B1. And next line B2, C2, A2, B2. This much only you need to study about cross multiplication. First, x, y, 1. Like this we will write. And we will start with the y coefficient of the first equation. B1, C1, then that rotation, cyclic rotation, it will come B1, C1, A1, B1. A1, B1, same way, second equation also we will write. Then see, x by B1, C2 minus B2, C1 equal to y by C1, A2 minus C2, A1 equal to 1 by A1, B2 minus A2, B1. So you need to study how to write this one. From that it is easy to write this one. So x by this one equal to y by this one equal to 1 by this one. So equating first one and last one, you will get the value of x. Equating second one and the last one, we will get the value of y. Like this cross multiplication is coming now. That's why it is calling cross multiplication method. One problem I will explain now. We can discuss more problem in the next class. Only one problem. Okay, then what we need to do? X, Y, 1. And first we need to write in that form, means minus y is equal to 0, this is equal to 0 in the standard form. So here what is A1? A1 is 2, B1 is 3, C1 is minus 5, A2 is 1, B2 is minus 1, C2 is 0. That if you want, you can note it that one separately. Or X, Y, 1. Like this we will write. Then starting from B1, 3, C1 minus 5, A1, then B1. Then next B2, C2, A2, B2. Like this you will write. Then x divided by 3 into 0, 0 plus, sorry, minus, minus 1 into minus 5, 0 minus plus 5 is equal to y by minus 5 into 1, minus 5 minus 0 into 2, 0 is equal to 1 by 2 into minus 1, minus 2 minus 1 into 3, 3. So we are getting like this equation. First equation comes, sorry, x by minus 5 is equal to y by minus 5 is equal to 1 by minus 5. Equating these two, x by minus 5 is equal to 1 by minus 5. So x is equal to, this is going to that side, minus 5 by minus 5 is equal to 1. And equating these two, we will get y by 5 is equal to 1 by minus 5, y by minus 5. So y is equal to minus 5 by minus 5 is equal to 1. So we got the value of x equal to 1 and y equal to 1. Like this we will apply. You don't do this problems from cross multiplication, that we can discuss to next class. Just to go through how cross multiplication process is coming. Problems we can do in the next class. Okay students, thank you.